Hello and welcome to Romero Threads on YouTube, where it's all about embroidery. In today's video, I am going to show you how to embroider on the sleeves of a polo shirt. You've probably heard me say it before that polo shirts are one of the most profitable, most straightforward garment to embroider. And it's definitely one of the most popular ones just because every business, every company, every organization, everybody needs a polo shirt. Specifically, left chest logos, those are projects that will never go out of style. Now, something that's very popular with polo, especially left chest, is definitely a sleeve design. The perceived value of a side logo, okay, can take your polo shirt from looking very basic and taking it to another level where it gives it a premium look. Today, I want to show you how we go about setting up our sleeves. Okay, usually if we're doing a polo shirt, I would say 50% of the time, we're going to do a sleeve. Okay, let's keep the video short and sweet. Let's get into the details for hooping our sleeves. I have the Mighty Hoop, the Freestyle. Okay, this is the 5.5, but I am not going to use this size, the 5.5. And that is because these golf polo shirts, they are pretty tight on the sleeves. All right, so like I mentioned in my previous video, all right, you don't want to stretch the sleeve. When it comes time to hooping, you don't want to have to stretch it just to make it over. All right, so let me show you how I go about doing this. So I do use I use the frame, but I use this hoop here. I introduced it in the last video, okay? But this is your 4.375 round, okay? This is your round hoop. This one here. Okay, so when I put it here on the Freestyle, fits good. And I have this clearance here, as you can see. I have a clean flush clearance here. Of course, like all of our other stations, I have my backing. So you already know what backing I use. I use the All Stitch. Let's kind of get a good view. I don't know if I've ever zoomed in into this view. But you can see how it's kind of, it has a usually cutaway, performance cutaway. They're squared. This one's squared, but at a diagonal. All right, so it helps with the puckering and the pulling of the stitches, especially when you're working with the thin polo shirts. All right, let's see if we can get a good view. The way I like to cut my backing, I just cut this in half. I don't have to fill up the full hoop here. You could if you want to, okay? But here, since this is a smaller hoop, okay, it's gonna get a good grip of my hoop here. I wanna make sure I have my logos well placed. First thing, you have a natural fold here. This is showing you where is this center line, okay? You could just follow the way this shirt is made, the way it's folded. It has a natural fold on the shirt. Very important here, you have a decision to make here on your shirt, okay? This is your center mark here. You have your center mark, which I can mark here. This here on the sleeves, some of it is a judgment call, okay? Because this here is your perfect center line on the sleeve, but sometimes you don't want to be perfectly on the center. You want to be a little bit rotated inside the body just so the logo could hang a little forward of the body. So I have my center mark here. I know that I kind of want to be to the right of my center. All right, so I made a center line here. Okay, you can barely see it a little, especially this logo that I have. All right, it's a rectangle, so I know I should shift a little bit more forward. Okay, that's all judgment call, but the safe way to go, you can always just go straight down the middle. Okay, but if you want to use a judgment call and you want to go forward a little, always go forward. Never take it back. Okay, you don't want the logo to be sitting somewhere behind the person. Let's bring this back. We got perfect view here. One important key feature I want you to notice is these straight lines going from left to right and from the bottom up. Okay, these are going to help me line up my shirt. Now notice how my sleeves, without even trying, goes over through the station. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to use this line here. All right, this line that you see here, and I'm just going to line up my sleeve with that line. I actually have the camera right over this view, so I'm looking at the camera. Okay, but I know I'm good here. Very important, because at this point, there is no room for error. All right, once you have your shirt perfectly lined up, okay, so push down hard here. Okay, we are good, good connection. I like to continue pushing these plastic ones down while I'm pulling out. All right. And bam, give it a quick look. And you can see that we're straight right here. All right, let's take it to the equipment. Let's stitch this out real quick. Okay, I got you a good front row view here on the equipment. Now, just real quick on the needles that I use for embroidering polo shirts, I use the Gras Becker. This is the 7010, okay? So it's a little smaller than your normal 7511. All right, so when you insert, okay, of course, you want your notch to be open here or however your equipment is set up. All right, but the big important thing is up here, you want to make sure your backing clears the needle plate. And you want to put your hand under here, down in the back, and make sure your sleeve clears the arm. Okay, once everything is good, now we trace it. Okay, let's talk about tracing, okay? Tracing is very important at this point, just because you don't want to be either too close or too high from that seam. So I made my line here. I already have a pre-made line, and it kind of tells me where I want to be at. All right, very important. You could do a silhouette trace. This is just showing me exactly where my needle is going to travel throughout the design. All right, once we're ready to go. Let's stitch this. It's always a good idea to have these tied pins just to take it off easy. All right, so let's see our logo. I still have to cut the backing here, but logo, look at that, nice and clean. All right, so let's zoom into our design, give you a good view. Okay, I also want to take this time as we're looking at the stitching and just to announce that we are now officially an authorized affiliate for Mighty Hoop. Okay, so I do have a promo code now. If you place an order using our promo code, Romero Threads, you will get free shipping on your order. You have to place your order via phone. So I'll leave the phone number down below in the description. And also, once you're on the phone with somebody from Mighty Hoop, they can also answer any of your questions, okay? Also, if you have any compatibility type questions, okay, they are always there to help you. All right, thank you for stopping by. Thank you for hanging out. And if you have any questions, like always, leave them down below, because whatever question you have, trust me, about 5 or 10 other people have the same question as you. All right, so I'll catch you on the next episode. And like always, peace out.